Hello everybody, welcome to tonight's performance. Tonight we present to you two cantatas by Johann Sebastian Bach that have a very humorous side, something that we don't tend to associate with this composer. The first cantata is known as the Peasant Cantata, and it was set to music by Johann Sebastian Bach upon commission by none other than a tax collector in Leipzig called Ernst Friedrich Henrici. Henrici produced plays under the pen name of Picander, and he wrote this play because a friend of him called Dieskau had just inherited a large mansion and he wanted to do this as a gift for Dieskau. So he hires Johann Sebastian Bach to put music to this fantastic, very funny text. In this text, two peasants are trying to be refined. They're trying to improve on their image because they just heard they have a new governor and they want to be more sophisticated by the time they meet him. They don't quite get there yet, but they try very hard, as you will see. One of the techniques that Johann Sebastian Bach uses is to take actual folk tunes that people used to know very, very well and intertwine it with his music and with the text. So there is a lot of layers of depth that, unfortunately, we have lost through time. However, you might catch a glimpse of La Folie d'Espagne that he quotes in one of the soprano arias. As you can see, Bach has produced a very clever and very funny way to set this text, so I hope you enjoy it. Thank you.
schon immer her. Thank you. Thank you.
Zimmermann, and in that coffee house, Bach and his students performed a number of things, not only cantatas, but also concertos, sinfonias, and you name it. But this one in particular is very interesting because it sets another text by Picander, in which we have a young woman called Lisbon who loves coffee, and she does not want to give her daily dose of coffee, even though when her father Schlendrian is asking her to do so. What follows is a discussion between father and daughter. And at the end, she finds a great, great solution to all of these problems. Funny enough, during the time that this was written, Leipzig was known for the coffee vice. People enjoyed very much drinking coffee in many places. So this was absolutely appropriate for the time. I hope you enjoyed it. Cheers.
Ist einer Tochter Thank you. Thank you.